Welcome to Point Scene, and here's some tips and tricks of how to use and navigate Point Scene as a user. So you've been invited to Point Scene and you've activated your account. So once you've signed in, you'll be finding your different sites that you can log in and see. So I've opened up here just one project, and most likely you have only one project view. If the project already has data, you'll be seeing the orthophotos first, or all the 2D data. I can see what datasets I have turned on automatically up here in the top corner, and I can find all my layers when I click the menu button. So here you can see that actually I don't have my orthophotos on at all, but I actually have the background ortho on. So that's found over here. So this is just for make speeding things up, and you can see something on the map as soon as you come in. So if I take all of these off, we'll clean up the data sets over here and see what happens then. The data is organized by date. So here we have by capture date. I can turn on the orthophoto of a site, perhaps the DSM as well, and then the point cloud. So these are the three different types of data sets that can be found. So we don't show the or surface or the point cloud by default, so you have to turn them on by yourself. You can find them by via the date or type. And then we are now missing the map overlay that we used to have here. So it's disappeared over up here to maps. So now I will get my map layer on top as well to get some more details to be seen. Like this. You can organize the dates, the layers by dragging and dropping a whole group up and down, or even inside a data set. You can organize the datasets by date and name. So the newest one and the oldest one. And I'll turn off the maps over there. And then you can zoom in to see the data a little bit better. You can also use our compare tool against two different orthophotos. So I'll take the newest and the oldest dataset side by side, and then I can compare those two. I can add an overlay if I have a VMS or a map layer added. And I can perform measurements at the same time. So I can do distances, I can do areas, I can do volumes, can change the date of the data set down here. And I can do profile measurements. So I can exit even the compare tool and then still perform a profile measurement. So from the newest to the oldest, or the other way around, and 1, 2, and here I can see my profile. So these are the basic tools that you have in the 2D world, where you can see and compare and do some measurements. Once we jump into the point cloud view, we can turn on a point cloud, and you can jump into the point cloud for wherever in the map, or using the three dots and open point cloud. I want to jump in to see the green field over there, and I'll get a bird view of that area I just clicked. We have different effects and visualizations for the points. So edge effect gives some contrast, and adaptive points will enlarge the points that are a little bit more sparsely related. We also have measurement tools down here, so you can measure individual coordinates. You can measure distances and have the angle of the line as well. And then you can measure area. In addition, you can see the Z-Mali differences by using our elevation coloring option. So I can set it up. I can see my Z-values down here, about 29.9 and about 30.0 in the middle. So here I can see how the field is done, and there's no rainwater coming into the middle of the field. The measurements, you cannot save the measurements here, so they're just one-time measurements, and once you close the point cloud view, they'll be dismissed. So what if you don't have any data in your data set, you have an empty project you just started, then you have to start uploading data as well. So the upload happens from the option selection. You can upload photos, like or geotag photos. You can upload rasters, so orthophotos, aerial images, and then point clouds. So if I go up to upload raster, I can upload one or more rasters at the same time. Drag and drop. I just added a orthophoto and a DSM from the same area. We detect the EPSG code automatically. And the orthophoto type, and then as this is a DSM, I have to choose the DSM type for this one. Then you will give in the capture date and then hit next and upload, and then you'll be ready with those. The same thing with point clouds, so upload point clouds and then drag and drop one or multiple files. So if you upload multiple files, they will be all merged into the same view automatically. There's no separation. And here you give the date, name, and the EBSG code. If you want to duplicate the data set into another coordinate system, so if you're using InfraKit, this might be something you need to do. You can duplicate it here at the uploading version. And that's it. You will get an email once the upload, the processing is done. So once the upload is done, you can close the browser, and once the processing is done, then you'll get an email. So the processing time depends heavily on the data set, how big it is, how wide of an area it covers, so there's no set in stone time that we can say how long it takes or how big data sets we can actually handle. So it's all up to the variables that you have in the data. But if we're talking about gigabytes of data and like a drone area of flight or something like that, then it's okay. But if you have mega big files, you can ask our support for more help and how to do those files a little bit better. Once we go in to another project and we want to share the data outwards, here we have data sets that are fluent in different times, in different areas, and we want to give one big link for all the orthophotos. I can go into options and publish and manage data. So in this project, we have the automation compilation ready to be used. So in this link, you have all the data sets in one link, and it's automatically updated every time there's a new data set coming in. So this is an extra feature for big projects. If you're a regular license, you'll be able to publish and choose the different data sets that you want to make into a group and then publish share link. You can do one link or multiple links at the same time into the same link. VMS will take up to 15 minutes to update, and that supports local coordinate systems. But all the rest, so VMTS, TMS, XYZ, will be supported immediately. So you can use the XYZ in InfraKit, for example, and then you'll get the group layer or one single layer from this link automatically there. All owners of the site can access these links and create them. You can create them with point clouds and orthophotos. So here's the orthophotos, and then point cloud links are down below. The link works in InfraKit and Trimble Connect, and we have a file that you can download over here that works in Trimble Connect and web version, and then Thekla Civil and Thekla Structures programs. So you just go in and add your link into your project settings in InfraKit. So you go project settings and map tile layer, create map tile layer, and add your XYZ here. You'll go into the map and you will be able to choose your data set from the list. And there you have it. The data is shared to all the project members. And with Trimble Connect, you have the file that we downloaded onto the computer. You can add it to your project folder in the web version. And once you click that button in the 3D viewer, you'll be able to see your point cloud together with your model. So that's all for now. And if you have any questions, please reach out to support@pointscene.com, and we'll be happy to help you with any questions you have.